And one policy that tries to more closely approximate LRU is the so-called pseudo-LRU policy. So it's really trying to approximate LRU, but sometimes it doesn't exactly match it. So let's look at an 8-way set associative cache. And with the pseudo-LRU policy, what we keep is one bit per line in the set. So in an 8-way set associative cache, we will have a one bit associated with each line, as opposed to 3 bits that we would need for LRU counters. So how does pseudo-LRU work? All of the bits start out at 0. And what we will do is every time a line is accessed, we will set its bit to 1. So for example, this one becomes 1, this one becomes 1, then this one becomes 1. As long as there is at least one 0 bit here, we keep doing this. And if we ever need to replace something, we pick among the blocks whose bits are 0. So all the recently accessed blocks will have the bits at 1 and thus be saved from replacement. Eventually, however, if we have a lot of hits, so for example, in this particular state, we will pick the least recently used block because it's the only one that has a 0 bit. Eventually, however, all of the bits will be set. So eventually we will have this become 1, and now we cannot replace anything. So we detect this situation where all the bits have become 1, and when we set the last 0 bit to 1, we zero out the remaining bits. So now we have state that is similar to what not most recently used would tell us. We only know what was the most recently used block. For the rest of them, we need to pick at random if something needs to be replaced. But as we start accessing some other blocks, we get a better idea of which ones are more and which ones are less recently used. So at any given point in time, this pseudo-LRU policy is somewhere between the NMRU and the LRU policy. We have seen that when one bit is set, we are effectively implementing the NMRU policy. When more than one bit is set, but not almost all of them, we are in between. And when all but one are set, we are implementing the true LRU policy because we know exactly which one block is the least recently used. So this policy behaves somewhere in between LRU and NMRU in exchange for using more bits. But it's also very simple because on a hit, all we have to do is set the bit that corresponds to the block, which can be done very quickly and efficiently. So as far as activity on a cache hit is concerned, both pseudo-LRU and NMRU have much less activity than LRU, which helps us with both power and also hit time of the cache.